All right, Mr. Claxton's Algebra 1 students. What are we trying to do today? We have our objectives here. We're multiplying and dividing expressions that have variables. The reason why we're trying to do this in general is so we can see the structure in expressions and see what the operations do to those expressions with variables. We want to try to rewrite expressions in an equivalent manner. We use multiplication for that by using the distributive property. As you see here in 24, we distribute or multiply. That's what's happening there. We're multiplying. When you say distribute, we are multiplying that negative 2 through the quantity 6x plus 3. To give a good visual of that, you can see negative 2 times 6x plus negative 2 times 3. Understand that the desired way that I want you to write that answer is negative 12x minus 6. Negative 12x plus negative 6, if you do it too much, it will result in you missing points. Moving on, we have another example of the distributive property here. And this 1 was not in there, but I'm always allowed to multiply by 1 by the identity property of multiplication. So I can say 1 multiplied by that quantity. And that makes it a little easier for some students because we take negative 1 multiplied by 3 and negative 1 multiplied by minus x squared. Right? Negative multiplied by a negative will result in a positive. I had to combine like terms to get my answer, my final answer. Okay, go ahead and draw a rectangle around that. So here we're using multiplication to multiply through a quantity. What I wanted you to do tonight was to divide through a quantity. We're dividing through a quantity when we do an example. You know, we're thinking division, but we write it as a vertical fraction. So we're thinking division, write it as a vertical fraction. You should show your work, show some form of work. Some people will be able to skip from this step right here, straight down to the answer. And understand, all I did to get from what we have to the next step, or first step of the work, is I just divided 2x divided by negative 2, and then I divide 8 by negative 2 as well. So you can see that. I could probably give that two eyes and make it look like a rabbit. Okay, all right. Let's stay on topic, right? So you can see what I did there, and all I did here is I kicked that x down to the middle. It's not allowed to be in the denominator. It must either be right there in the middle or in the numerator. What this helps us to do when it's in the middle right there in line with that solidus, 2 over negative 2 is the same as negative 1. So that's negative 1x minus 4. And again, you can see here I wrote that w squared right down there in between. And feel free to pause at any time to review these examples that we did in class today. So in order to complete this example right here, we have to consider 15a minus 20 divided by negative 5. Now I'm looking to see if I have any common or like terms in the numerator. And if I do have any like terms in the numerator, I do need to combine them or add them together. I don't, so I just start my division. 15a over negative 5, that's 15 over negative 5a, minus 20 over negative 5. And we all know 20 over negative 5, well, 20 divided by negative 5, right? Negative 4. That's, we're thinking division, remember. So then you get minus a negative, same as plus a positive. And I'm only allowed to use that minus one time. I use it one time there, and I use the negative with the 5 one time. All right, feel free to pause and review any of these. You know, I've set the work up for you. In the critical thinking problems, you definitely want to combine like terms first. So see if there's any like terms that you can combine here. Well, like I see a 2b squared and a minus 10b squared. That is the question. All right. So combine the like terms, I see a negative 3b minus a 1b. Combine the like terms and then take it through that division, that process of division. Here, you would just multiply by the reciprocal. So you're going to take 3x squared minus 6x plus 9 over 1 and multiply it by 3x. So really you're just going to be distributing that 3x through. I hope that this has been somewhat helpful. If you do have any questions, okay, write them down for tomorrow's class or email them to me.